Hi there, this is Ranjit, and in this video of Tech Tips, I'm going to talk about home theaters and AVR receivers and what you should know about them before purchasing one. No way I'm an expert in AVR receivers, but I have purchased quite a few. For example, I own three of them, and I've also helped some of my friends to purchase AVRs and home theater systems. Again, the thing is that in India, if you buy an entry level or what do you say, AVR receiver, it comes bundled with the speakers. That's why we call them home theater systems. But if you purchase advanced receivers, you'll just get the receiver. And actually, I own three of them. One is for my parents. This is the Onkyo entry level receiver. It's a home theater in a box. You get speakers and everything. Another one, this one, I use it in my living room. This is sort of the mid range. It also has network capabilities. And the other one that I recently purchased just last year is a Yamaha receiver that I use in my office. But all of these differs in terms of its capabilities. And let me actually show you what are the important things that you have to take into account. And before we continue, you might ask, why do we need these AVR receivers? If you want that home theater kind of sound experience, then you need these AVR receivers. Because let's say if you watch your movies on Blu-ray or even DVD, you'll notice that there are options that the audio feed might be in 5.1 audio or even 7.1 audio. And to get that experience of that audio or even Dolby Atmos, you need receivers that can decode that signal. And these receivers support multi-speaker setup like 5.1, 7.1. And again, if you even have, satellite TV like Tata Sky, etc. And if you have HD feed, they provide the audio in Dolby so you can enjoy that audio experience. And for those things, you need receivers. Also, I connect my receivers with gaming consoles to get that immersive sound experience. So if you really need that theater kind of sound experience in your house, you have to connect your digital devices to a AVR receiver. And the AVR receiver will actually decode that sound signal to give you that multi-surround sound experience. So this is the front panel of my Yamaha receiver, and it also has a USB port. USB port is not available on every device, but some of the advanced ones have that. Some advanced receivers also have this. You can just place it and it will auto calibrate all the speakers and the levels because every room is a little bit different. So it makes the job of calibration really easy. This is one with the Onkyo that I got, but my Yamaha receiver also has that, but only with advanced receivers you have that option. Also, with every receiver, you'll have a display which gives you an idea what's happening and what is the audio it is decoding. You'll also notice that all AVR receivers have a lot of buttons, but mostly you will be just using the remote to actually control. So it's important to look at the remote because in the last 4-5 years, I never actually used these physical buttons and I always use the remote. Again, with advanced receivers, for example, this is my Onkyo one. They have a lot more functionality that you can do directly from the remote. In fact, the Onkyo receiver, the high end, also has a zone 2 where I can actually have different speakers in a different room and I can just switch to them. So again, it depends upon the speaker's functionality. Again, it's a good idea to look at the remote control and how user-friendly the remote is. The main thing on the receiver is the ports, and for that you have to look at the back. Here you'll have all the options and the connectivity options. The most important these days is the number of HDMI inputs that you'll get on your receiver. Again, this is the Yamaha entry level receiver, hence it has only 4 HDMI inputs, as you can see. So I can connect actually 4 different devices. I have connected my Chromecast, WDTV, Xbox One and PS4, and the HDMI out actually connects to your television. So if you have more devices like a Tata Sky, a DVD box, etc., you might need a receiver with more HDMI ports. Generally, the higher end receivers have even 6 to 8 HDMI ports. So that is very important. Again, it will have the normal component inputs and even inputs for audio, digital audio like ToshLink. This one has 2 and also coax in for digital audio. Again, it also has standard AV inputs that are common. So essentially, you just connect all your digital devices that you connect to the TV to the AVR receiver, and from the AVR receiver, it will go to the television. And this is the section where you actually connect your speakers. This one for the main left and right speakers, and these are for the surround speakers. Again, for advanced receivers, you don't have that spring-loaded system, but again, it will have banana plugs and stuff like that. Now moving to subwoofers, they come in two variants, that is active subwoofer or a passive subwoofer. With an entry level system, you'll only have a passive subwoofer. For example, my entry level Onkyo receiver only has a passive subwoofer. That means I cannot connect any third party subwoofer to this AVR receiver. But my other Onkyo and the Yamaha receiver supports active subwoofer. So if your AVR receiver supports an active subwoofer, it'll have a port like this. And the advantage is that you're not limited to the subwoofer that you get with the receiver. For example, let's say you want a more powerful subwoofer. If you have a sub out option, so it's important to have this sort of functionality if you want to use a third party subwoofer. And again, only the basic AVR receivers don't have this option. If you are looking for a mid-range to a high-end AVR receiver, it'll have a dedicated sub out option. And this is my Yamaha powered subwoofer, and as you can see, it has a electrical input that connects, and we also have a power on off switch. And if you move towards the top, this is the port that will connect to our AVR receiver, and we actually have a dedicated knob over here using which you can actually control the amount of bass that you would like to have. So this is what you get with a powered subwoofer. Another important thing that you have to consider is the power rating of your AVR receiver. What are the type of speakers it can drive? Generally, it's in watts per channel, that is per speaker. And generally, even with entry level speakers, it'll generally have a rating of about 80 watts, which is pretty loud, but you can get even receivers with 100 or 120 watts and so forth and so on. So you have to also look at the watt rating if you want to drive very high end speakers. Also, generally with the home theater systems, the speakers that are provided are just okay. They're pretty small, but I opted for this Onkyo tower speakers, which provide much better audio output compared to the supplied speakers that I got. So you can also shop for third party speakers. Another thing that I have noticed in AVR receivers, and this is sort of important, and I thought that every AVR receiver will support this functionality, because even my basic Onkyo receiver and the mid-range Onkyo receiver had this feature, is known as audio pass-through when it's on standby. That means, let's say you have your AVR receiver connected to your television and you have all that surround sound, etc. But let's say you're just watching news and stuff. You don't want that surround sound and etc. You just want the sound to come out from your television. The thing is that with the Onkyo receiver, if you just put the receiver on standby, that's off, the sound gets transmitted from the TV speaker. But that was not present, surprisingly, on my Yamaha receiver. And later on, I found out that that feature on Yamaha receivers is only on the higher end. So it's a good idea to note about this feature. Another thing that I have already mentioned is that high-end receivers have a lot more options, like networking options. For example, my Onkyo receivers has a Wi-Fi port. It'll also have a USB port, and some actually receivers also have Bluetooth functionality and even AirPlay mode. So again, and obviously it also has DLNA functionality. So if you need those sort of features, networking features, then you have to check, because generally most of the basic receivers don't have those features. Another important thing that you have to look at is what are the types of audio streams that your receiver can decode. Generally, most of the receivers will be able to decode the basic, like the Dolby, Dolby Plus, or DTS or DTS Plus. But if you have something really exotic or the new formats, then you have to check if those are supported. Also, most of the receivers will support 1080p, but only the new high-end receivers support 4K video. So again, if you have a 4K television, you have to take that also into account. So these were some of the points that you have to look when you're purchasing your first home theater or an AVR receiver. Again, there is a lot. Again, as I mentioned, generally the speakers that you get with the bundle are not that high quality. So if you want to improve the experience, you can go with aftermarket speakers that will really improve the experience, but they can get really expensive. Again, I can't touch upon every topic in this video. So this video should give you a basic idea about AVR receivers and home theaters. And I hope this video was helpful. And if you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching. This is Ranjit, and I hope to see you in my next video.